All right, back for part two, I guess. So I'm gonna be reacting to more songs that you guys have picked. So yeah. Right, so first song, this person suggested two songs, and this is one of them. This is The Radiators from Space Television Screen. So yeah, let's see. When's it gonna start? When's it gonna start? Oh, okay. I love this like chord progression. Like it's what's it called? The 12-bar blues. That's kind of what it is, I guess. Yeah, I think that's what it is. I love songs with that chord progression. You know, it's overused in a sense. I think there's so many songs that have it, but it's just so catchy. But yeah, this is cool. Okay, I wasn't sure the first chorus around, but is he saying I'm gonna smash my Telecaster through the television screen? I think that's what he's saying. That's what he's saying. I'm gonna smash my Telecaster through the television screen. I like it. Why do songs always fade out at like the coolest part? Like I want, like they start doing some like solo or something, and like it starts fading out. Anyways, that was a really good song actually. Let's see, when was this released? Ah, oh, 1977. Yeah, that sounds very 1977, I will say. For punk rock, at least. Cool, alright. No way, they only have 219 subscribers? Dang, that was a good song. Yeah, thank you for that one. That was actually really cool. Gonna have to check out the rest of that album. All right, so the next song that this person suggested was Fia. I think that's how you would say it. Feminazi. So let's take a listen, I guess. She has a hint of Kathleen Hanna from Bikini Kill in her voice, I think. It's a little bit similar. Tell me it's not relevant. Don't tell me it's not relevant. Cause I'm still a brush, we're getting paid less. Judge my looks and the way we dress. I don't wanna bring you down, man. I just want us to meet in the middle. I am a feminist. You're so a feminist. This one too, it's cool. Is she speaking? I can't. It sounds like multiple. I don't know. Does anyone know what language? I don't know. I'm a feminist, yeah! I am a feminist. Just so you're so a feminist. Just me a feminist. Me, I'm a feminist. Without you, I'm a feminist, yes! Gonna do like one last like hit where it's like no. In Colombia le rezamos. Don't play something else, please. Thank you. That was good. Also, I really like that. Whoever suggested those two, you have very good taste, my friend. I'll probably have to check out more of this band as well. Because I love myself some girl punk rock, so. Oh, here, go back to the original song, will you? Okay, when did this come out? Because the, like, it sounds quite modern, like production kind of sounds like that. Oh, 2016, so. 8 years ago? So I was eight then. Yeah, 8 years ago. 2016 was a good year, and simultaneously a bad year at the same time. But it was the last year I actually felt like I was alive and not just existing. All right, yeah, that was cool. It was cool. I liked it. All right, and the last song is King Diamond, A Mansion in Darkness. I know King Diamond is very popular. I haven't really listened. So, yeah. What am I doing with my mouth? All right. Let's do it. Why does it sound like Mickey Mouse? Does it not? Okay. I'll give it a little more time, but that kind of sounded like Mickey Mouse. This doesn't, but. Okay, that's a cool riff. That's a cool riff. I like that. But I mean, like, those vocals don't sound easy to do, but it's very, I don't know what the word would be. Kind of sounds like, have you seen those videos of like Axl Rose, like of Guns N' Roses Live, like in the past year or two, and like Axl Rose, his voice is just like shot, and he sounds literally exactly like Mickey Mouse. I feel bad, but I remember talking about that with, this is so random. I remember talking about that. I was like, I had to get an ultrasound for something, and I was talking with the like nurse lady about that, because we were talking about music, because she asked me what I liked, and then she's like, do you like Guns N' Roses? And I was like, eh, not really, because I'm not a huge fan of Axl Rose singing to begin with, but this kind of sounds like what he sounds like now. If you haven't heard it, which I mean, it's gone like viral, I guess you probably have, but if you haven't, look up like Guns N' Roses, like 2023 or 2024 even. I don't know if they have they done any shows this 2024? I don't know. But yeah. It sounds like that. I just got way off topic.
They fall away.
I can't. It's like it's a good song. Like I don't hate it. Like the actual instrumental of it, I guess, just the actual music is good, but I can't help but laugh every time I hear the, what do you call that, like falsetto? I don't know. And I feel like if I listened to this in front of anybody, not that it would matter, but like if I was playing this and my parents heard it, they would laugh at me because they already laugh at everything I listen to. But they would think it's silly. And I'm just thinking, I feel like, I don't know, it's like I can get past the like silly sounding, the silliness of like such high vocals where it just sounds kind of over the top. But like at the same time, it's still funny. Like, even if it's good, I'm still gonna laugh at it. That's like, you know, making fun of your sibling. Like you love them, or at least, you know, I love my sister. Not romantically, but I don't live in Alabama. Don't worry. But you know, like still make fun of your like family, you know, in a way. But it's in a loving way. I don't know. I don't know. Does that make any sense at all? Now I'm just gonna get accused of incest. That's great. That's so great. Okay, let's continue. That's cool. Is that all? Is that all? Wow, that's all. All right. I mean, the album cover looks cool. I don't know what's going on here. Why did I just break out into an accent for that? I don't know. I know. When did this come out? Will it tell me? In 1987. I mean, that makes sense. It sounds like it. Not that I really know what 1987 sounds like because I didn't live in 1987. I wish I did, but at the same time, I don't. You know, like, it's like, I don't know. Half of me is like, yeah, you know, I'd love to go where there's like, you know, no social media and no, you know, iPhones and all that stuff, and you know, stuff like that. But at the same time, it's like, could I really survive without that all? I mean, I probably, you know, I probably could. To be fair, I don't really use my phone that much, except for listening to music. And you know, I post on YouTube, obviously. But you know, that's not like a At this, that doesn't take very long. Most of my time on my phone is just like staring at the home screen, or like, the weather app looks really nice today, or like the settings app or something, because like I get so bored. I get so bored. I get bored of the phone. You know, I can't doom scroll like other people. That's boring. So, you know, I just sit and either stare at the wall or I stare at the home screen. So, yeah. This is perfect. This ad to my badass daughter. If fate whispers to you, you can't withstand the storm. Whisper back, I am the storm. Wrap yourself up in this and consider a big hug. Love, Dad. Why am I getting this ad? That. Oh, I love those, like, cheesy t-shirts or stuff on them where it's like, says stuff like that. Maybe I should get it. Oh, if you know what I love so much? Like, those shirts that'll say like dog mom or something, but you'll see some like grown man wearing it. I think that's so funny. Like, I've tried to get like a shirt like that where it's like number one dad or something random at like Walmart or something, but my mom wouldn't let me. I think it's so funny. I don't know why. I'm gonna do it one day. Maybe I should get this blanket. Let me click the link. Let's see how much it is. Oh my gosh. It's $35. How much for the two extra large? Dude, that's so much money. $90 for this blanket. What in the world? Oh, let me see the pictures. Oh, no, she's happy. What the heck, Barbara? Who gave this to you? Oh, oh, she's outside. Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, you can do it from mom? Oh, maybe that's why Barbara is holding it. I don't know why I just gave this lady the name Barbara. Oh, there's the daughter. Yeah. All right. That was funny. That's actually really funny. If only it wasn't so expensive from this random website I've never heard of. So that's all the songs for now. Ow, I hit myself in the leg. I don't want the videos to be too long, so I'm gonna stick to like three a video. I've always sucked at doing this, doing the number three with my hands. When I was little, I couldn't do it at all. Guess I could just do this. But nobody does that. Do they? Anyways, that song was okay, not horrible. Mickey Mouse-esque vocals. But if someone put this on, I wouldn't yell at them to turn it off. So yeah, there it is. We did it. Again, suggest more. If you got more, if you don't have more, then yeah. I'm gonna go buy that blanket now.